What's up, everybody? Steve from BCA Media, and this is Tech Talk. All right, so I'm here today to do a quick review on the Panasonic GH4. Now, I personally just picked one up to shoot the majority of my video on, and I must say, I'm super impressed with this camera. Maybe a Micro Four Thirds, which turns a lot of people off. However, it is a very capable camera. There is one issue, and it's actually something that Panasonic brought on to themselves. A little while back, they came out with an update for the firmware, and it was called 2.3. Now, what that allowed a lot of people to do is get V-Log, which we've been waiting for a really long time. It gives that really great range that a lot of other cameras seem to have, like the Sony A7S and everything else. Now, we've been waiting for it for a while, and Panasonic came out with the 2.3 update, which gave everybody V-Log. That was a problem. They didn't mean to do that, apparently. They meant to charge everybody $100 to essentially download and wait for V-Log. So they quickly took it down and they came out with 2.4. Now there were some people who already updated the firmware to 2.4, like myself. Now this posed a problem. You cannot backdate firmware. I contacted Panasonic and they said, no, it's not possible. You cannot go back. So fortunately myself, I did have to fork over the $100 for V-Log, but for you, the viewer, anybody that does have a Panasonic GH4, do not update your firmware yet. If you are on an older firmware, the original firmware, or a previous update before 2.3, down there in the link, I'm going to actually provide you free of charge the 2.3 that Panasonic took down. Now, all we ask is you subscribe to our channel, Tech Talk, and also to BCA Media, if you can, my personal one. Now, another thing I wanted to show you GH4 users, if you're not already familiar with, is the speed booster. I personally have the MetaBoom speed booster on mine, and I love it. However, once again, there's a problem. I always like to say the goods and the bads. For you Nikon lens users, you got screwed, like myself. The Nikon mount, unfortunately, does not have any metal electrodes for the autofocus for the Nikon lenses. The Canon people do have that option. So if you do shoot a little bit of video, it's not so bad. However, for photos, it's actually the main reason why I kept my old Nikon, so I can still shoot photos and then use this for video. Until Speed Booster comes out with a autofocus. Now, I did contact Speed Booster, and they said it's a great idea, but they have no idea when of dates will be out for the autofocus Nikon adapter. So right now, unfortunately, you're going to have to wait, like myself. Once it does come out, it's probably going to be around the same price as the Canon Speed Booster autofocus, which is about, I think, $200 more than the standard one, which is about $400. So once that does come out, you'll probably see these original ones drop in price. Myself included will probably sell mine to get the autofocus one, because of course you can always turn it off. You don't always have to use autofocus, but it's nice to have the option, especially with photos, quick snaps and everything. You can't manual everything. It sucks. Thank you for joining us on Tech Talk, and don't forget to subscribe to both of our channels. And if you like this review, make sure to leave a comment as well. Thanks. See you next time.